Every element comes with a default display setting. It helps to have a good understanding of how each display setting affects an element, as well as how it affects the content around that element. In this video lesson, we'll touch on block, inline block, inline, flex, and none. Each block element starts on a new line, and it takes up all the available width inside its parent element. As we drag in these elements, the section, the heading, each of these paragraphs, we can see this in action. Now, on block elements, you can always add your own width and a height, but by default, block elements will push the next element down. That's block. Inline block elements are as wide as the content inside. We're copying and pasting this image several times. Too many times? Maybe. Bad design? That's debatable. But the answer is yes. This does illustrate that inline block elements flow in line, wrapping when the content hits the boundary of their parent, just like in a text document. These all have the same class applied, so let's adjust the sizing so we can see this wrapping in a bit more detail. Also, inline block elements react to text alignment settings from their parent elements. So if we select the parent and align the text to the center, the inline block elements center. That's inline block. Inline is just that, it's inline. Inline is the default for content like a text span or a text link. Inline content ignores any values you've entered for dimensions and only respects text content. So if we're changing the text inside an inline element, we can see that the size is based on that text. If you want to resize inline elements, you should be using inline block as the display type. Next is flex. Flex is super powerful. It can behave just like a block element, and it's a great way to create layouts and align elements. We've created highly specific content that covers flex in more detail. For now, let's move on to display none. This lets you completely hide an element, or more specifically, any element which has this class applied. It won't just make the element invisible. The browser renders the page as if the element doesn't exist. If you lose sight of your element, which is bound to happen when using display none, don't fret. It's in the navigator, right where you left it. You can simply select the element and go back over to the style panel. Change back to one of the other display settings, and you'll have access to the element right on the canvas. So, block elements, they start on a new line and they take up the full width of the parent. Inline block elements, as wide as the content inside, and they wrap when they hit the inner boundary of their parent element. Inline, default for text spans or text links, the content is inline right alongside text. Flex, they can behave like block elements, but we can use them for layouts, alignment, and none. Hide an element completely so it's not even rendered by the browser. That's a quick overview of the display setting properties.